The old Madison Square Elementary School is now the new home of the Bluford Drew Jemison STEM Academy. Today I am with R. Anthony Mills, Vice Chairman of their Board of Directors and Acting Chief Financial Officer, and Principal Kelvin Bridgers. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Glad to be with you.
Thank you for having us.
So Mills, tell us where the name Bluford Drew Jemison came from.
Bluford Drew Jemison STEM Academy comes from three prominent African Americans. Guy Bluford, first African American astronaut. Dr. Charles Drew, of course, who did the groundwork for what we now know as the blood bank. And Dr. Mae Jemison, first African American woman in space.
Now, why did you choose these three individuals as the founding names of this particular institution? What were you hoping that their witness would inspire for your young people?
Well, the founders of the school thought it was important to ensure that the name represented the focus, which is STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And these were the three individuals that they thought exemplified that goal.
What is your mission, and why did you choose a STEM curriculum for educating boys?
So the mission of this school is to focus on preparing boys for secondary and post-secondary education. Mm-hmm. The STEM curriculum, because as we move forward in this global economy, we wanted to ensure that the young men are prepared for the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
How old is your school? How many students are you educating on your two campuses, and what are the grade levels?
So the school was founded in 2006. We're educating between the two campuses close to 900 boys. We have 6th through 8th grade at the East Campus and currently 6th through 10 at the West Campus, and we'll be filling in for the next 2 years until we reach the 12th grade.
Why are there two campuses? Why did you decide in a place where we're moving to having 6th through 12 education, why are you sticking with a middle school model that's separate from a high school model?
Well, this East Campus is our flagship campus and is really the home of Bluford Drew Jemison. But we have two campuses because we had an opportunity to move into a format that would allow us to do 6 through 12 to see if we could get those young men moving to proficient and advanced levels all the way through the 12th grade and then push them to the higher achieving colleges, Ivy League colleges in the country.
Why is your school dedicated to only educating boys?
Well, you know, when you look at the data from the state of Maryland in terms of the number of children that are incarcerated, particularly in the Baltimore City area, it is the boys, primarily African-American boys between the ages of 11 and 17.
Sure.
So when you look at this traditional middle school for boys, we want to look at what group primarily needs more of a focus in academic to refocus out of incarceration and into education.
Right. And here in East Baltimore, that's a particular concern, correct?
Definitely. This particular area in East Baltimore is considered a high-crime area. Mm-hmm. However, we found that there are some very brilliant young men in this area. Sure. One of the things we wanted to do is to really encapsulate the brilliance that we really know exists in our young men. That's the reason for this institution and some of the things that we do, not only during the school day, but one of the reasons why we have an extended program as well that offer a variety of different type of extracurricular activities and culture activities for the young men as well.
Tell me about some of the positive outcomes you've seen from the work you're committed to here.
Well, it's a team effort. You know, it takes a group of people who are founders. You know, it takes a board of directors that's committed to, you know, providing the resources to put these programs together. And, of course, a tremendous administrative team, teachers, parents, et cetera, and community stakeholders as a part of this process. But we are very proud that at least 60% of our boys or better are attending citywide programs or private institutions as well throughout the city of Baltimore. You know, we feel good about the fact that culturally we've been able to cut back on the number of suspensions that have been occurring inside of our school, and we continue to get larger percentages of parent participation. Back to school night recently, we had 153 parents to show up for 320 boys.
That's outstanding.
So the process is going to take time, and we know that it's not anything that happens overnight, but I think that Bluford is heading in the right direction thus far.
Sounds like it. What are your future goals?
Well, you know, we are proud of the strides that we've made. We are realistic that we do have a long way to go. The ultimate goal is for every boy that attends this institution is to be proficient or advanced in standardized testing. And that is the task, not only here at Bluford, but of course all across America. So ultimately, being able to provide the proper resources and to put the right personnel, professional development, et cetera, that we need in order to put our teachers in position to move these children academically.
And Mills, tell us how the board of directors will help him achieve that goal.
Well, it's twofold. What we'll do from the governance side is we'll take the data from the schools, analyze it, and really come up with a model on how do you educate boys? And not just boys, but urban boys. What's the best way to educate them? And then from that, once we believe we have a solid plan, then we'll take that, and in terms of a business model, we look at expansion, looking at going from pre-K through five, looking at expanding outside of Baltimore to share what we've learned, to share our data results, and then move this model across the country.
Why do you think it's important for parents to consider supporting single-sex education options for their children?
I think the major component is the personal growth and development of individuals. Obviously, with the condition of America, the conditions of a lot of single-parent households, particularly African-American boys, many of them do not have a so-called standard nucleus family. And we're hoping that here at Bluford, with the structures that we have in place, strong male presence, as well as other programs that, you know, include male mentoring and other types of programs, manhood training programs, to help the young men to understand who they are, what their responsibilities are for themselves, for their families, and hopefully for their future families.
Well, thank you so much for sharing with us today the importance of single-sex education and the importance of a STEM curriculum when it comes to educating boys in Baltimore.
Thank you for having us.
And next, we will talk with a Bluford Drew Jemison scholar about his experiences here at the Academy.